since my left is Nick Wells, who is the partnership manager for Northwest for Sussex Rounds, and Nick is going to be our key contact over the next 4 years as we participate in Bike Life. But more importantly, he's going to answer all the questions that you may have following this brief presentation. So, first question that you may want to ask yourselves, what is Bike Life? Bike Life started in 2015. And it was a collaboration between Sustrans and Seven Cities to basically create what's the UK's biggest assessment of cycling in cities. In February of this year, Sustrans, through their private sector fund, which got an additional tranche of money to extend Bike Life for a further 4 years for three new cities. Liverpool City Region applied, and we actually became fourth in the process. But the gap between us and fourth, the city region and fourth, and the city that was in third was so close that Sustrans, to their great credit, went back and talked to their private sector funders and managed to secure a fourth place to participate in Bike Life, and hence the Liverpool City region now being a participating city in the programme from now until 2022. I think it's also important to stress as well that Bike Life traditionally has always been conducted at the city level. So Manchester, who were a Bike Life partner, is done in Manchester City Centre. I think for us, it's the first time it's actually been tested at a combined authority level. And again, that's kind of new and exciting for us. So it says on the slide there, there's now 10 cities participating in Bike Life. It's more like 14 now, isn't it, Nick, when we get everything on board. So what happens is, and again, Nick's got examples of these which he can show you. You get a report every 2 years. Our first report will be in 2020. And the report is a non-technical report, so it's actually quite an accessible document, and it really looks at the cycling infrastructure provision that people have across the city region, what travel habits are, and people's attitudes towards cycling. One thing that happens in bikers, we don't talk about cyclists, we talk about people who ride bikes. And that's a slightly different shift in the mindset, I think, and that's a really good way of looking at it. It also looks at the impact of people riding bikes. And this is fed by a survey of about 800 residents within the city. Because they're doing it at the city region level, we probably need to boost that survey sample a little bit around about the 1800 to 2000 mark. But again, we'll work that through with our colleagues in Sustrans. So what are the objectives? Well, basically, Bike Life is about normalising cycling for the city region. It's about increasing awareness of all of the benefits that cycling can bring, make places more livable cities. It's about securing the sustainability of the commitment to cycling as well over the longer term. And again, it's about encouraging this longer term planning for the provision of cycling. We're already starting to see this roll out now with the development of local cycling and walking infrastructure plans, these longer term 10-year plans for how we're going to build more and better cycling and walking infrastructure so we can get more people travelling more sustainably. And it's also about working with our partner cities and Bike Life. You know, if a city is doing something elsewhere that would benefit us here in the city region, it's all about learning best practice. It's not often about reinventing the wheel. Edinburgh have done some fantastic stuff as part of their Bike Life participation. Manchester have, a lot of the other cities have, and we can learn a huge amount from them, and we will be doing that over the next 4 years. So why cycling? This is a good slide, it's a really good slide. Well, you've got the top of the slide there, actually two quotes from one of the Bike Life reports that came out last year. And I can't even read it because that's small on the screen, but it will be in the slides when you take them out. Well, specifically for the city region, the latent demand for cycling is absolutely enormous. 66% of all of our journeys are 5 kilometres and under, yet only 2% of them could be made by bike. The graph you can see on the other side of the screen is a piece of work that I lead on the city region, which I just mentioned, this local cycling and walking infrastructure plan. The blue line you can see is the baseline, so which was taken from the 2011 census about people who couldn't cycle at the time of the census. The red line is the cycling and walking investment strategy. And if that was fully implemented across the city region, you can see the potential for growth in cycling as a consequence. And projects that we've done, if we fully implement the cycling and walking investment strategy, we will affect more change in the city region than we will anywhere else in the country. We're quite unique as well because we're relatively flat compared to other areas. Our geography, our topography, and our streetscape actually lends itself well to more people walking and cycling. And again, cycling also seems a little bit of a silver bullet, isn't it? You know, if cycling was a pill, it would be made free on the NHS because the benefits are innumerable. And just, you know, just a couple of things there about congestion, air quality, health, transport quality. In health alone, physical inactivity has a direct cost of about £1 billion a year to the NHS. In safety terms alone, and this is one of the big issues for us, again, with cyclists and pedestrians, the number of people who get killed is seriously injured on our roads. It's costing about £11 billion a year to the NHS. City-centred environments, if you get more people to city-centred environments, it's shown to have an impact on more people coming into those city-centred using facilities and shopping more. So, huge benefits from being a bike participant. But I'm not going to say anything else because we've got a really good video to show you that Susskind had made. This is fairly new, isn't it, Nick?
This video was made for the launch of the 2017 poll in November last year.
And keep your fingers crossed that the technology works.